Hey guys, welcome back to Bendy and the Dark Revival. Today we will be playing Chapter 5.
Stay close. This place isn't as safe.
Last time we found out that Henry, the original main character, is still alive. Old Track 76 is a quiet place these days. Ever since that terrible crash a few years back, people don't like to hang around. Too many strange things keep happening on this platform. Last week, one of the railmen told me they had reports of some train going through. That wasn't on schedule. There were figures standing in cars, staring through the windows, but it never stopped to let no one off. I'm sure someone says it was just a train.
The demon's evil continues to spread. This world.
First wolf does that and then it's like.
Be quiet!
What did you say?
Nothing. It was nothing.
Almost there. Just a quick stop. Won't take but a moment.
He just closed the door.
The subject will stand in the designated location. Lethal object detected. The subject will submit all weapons for further screening. Disarm now! Remain still for examination!
I want that Tommy gun. I want that Tommy gun for my wave.
The subject is cleared for entry!
I don't get that Tommy, then I'll be very mad. Right.
Welcome to the civilized world. How do you like my signal towers? They nullify the Ink Demon's powers, so he cannot pass them. I wish I could say I invented them, but it seems our friends at the Gent Corporation had a demon problem of their own long ago. And now, my dear, if you'll excuse me, I have a lot to prepare. We'll talk later, I promise. Besides, you must be very tired. A quick rest will do you good. Betty will show you to your room. She's my housekeeper, among other things.
You never actually killed the Ink Demon, did you?
No, he's too... too powerful to destroy. So we sealed him away, trapped him in a different form. One that was smaller, harmless.
Bendy.
It was a fitting prison. Although he seems to have found a way to free himself. But enough talk. We'll deal with that soon enough.
There's some nice fresh blankets all laid out for you. You'll be dreaming in no time.
Wait, Wilson? One more thing. If you needed my help, why didn't you just ask?
Would you have believed me?
Come along, and no more dawdling. This way now. Oh, you're here at last. It's so exciting finally having you with us. Now, to give you some bearings, we're currently standing in the south wing. Wilson's laboratory is downstairs, and then there's the north wing. The ink demon got in there a while ago, and ever since, we've had to keep the north wing locked up tight. I'm afraid it's fallen into ruins by now. All those juicy, lovely books gone to waste. Only keepers go there these days, and they'll tear you apart limb from limb if Wilson isn't with you. So, mind your distance, and you'll be just fine. Not very often I have guests to look after, especially one I can actually talk to. Almost everyone here either can't speak or they're completely mad. All right, here we are. Best room in the house. You should see where I sleep. Ugh. But this room, oh, just perfect. I saw to every detail. Bed is clean, the bathroom is on the left. Sorry about the stains. I did try my best to get them out. Did you have any questions?
Is it always night here?
It's always dark, if that's what you mean. For as long as I can remember.
Are you very old?
No. As far as I understand it, I'm something quite new. Although, I didn't turn out the way I was supposed to. One in a long line of failed experiments. But Wilson will keep trying.
And do you trust Wilson?
This is the realm of the ink demon. The shadow hangs over us all. I don't trust anyone. But Wilson takes care of me, keeps me safe. He once said I remind him of something he called his mother. Tell me, is that a good thing where you two are from?
I'm not sure. I don't think I ever had one.
Well, no matter. Now, I was told to make sure you get some sleep once you got here. So get nice and comfy and relax. I left something on the table that might just help you nod off. It's my own recipe. Works very fast. Just follow the instructions.
She's good. Drug.
Carefully.
She's asking me to drug myself.
Thanks,
son of a gun.
Of course. Oh. If you need anything good else, boy. I'll come straight away. I'm always up.
Gilson. What's a Gilson?
energy and hung.
Well, that didn't tell me anything.
I'm not gonna read this, I'm just gonna leave y'all here. This here, y'all read it. Y'all can pause it if y'all want.
So, I'm looking for
read it later.
A fish? There's gotta be one here somewhere.
Chocolate bacon soup.
That's a fish. Ugh, he's too fast.
I think I know what I'm supposed to do. I'm just gonna put it closed.
That did it. Looks like the fish is asleep.
Gotcha! You can't get away from me, little stinker.
Hello?
I forgot the Gilson again, didn't I? And there's some already ground up in the kitchen, too. I'll bring it up to your room straight away, shall I? Oh, and maybe you could put Harold back in his tank. He does so hate the dry air.
Oh well, moving this back.
Now, just 3 sips of water. 1. Two.
Okay, Bendy's gonna pee on what we call it. Something's gonna happen.
3.
Solve my little puzzle and return to your special chair. Then I'll throw this heavenly switch here. If you get the puzzle right, you walk away. Get it wrong, you fry. Let's begin.
The fox thinks the rabbit smells of elderberry. I couldn't see them sitting together.
The rabbit never sits with the bird, but he loves the playful company of the bear.
The pompous fox? Well, he wouldn't be caught dead sitting on the left. Far too pedestrian.
My friend the bear always sits next to the bird. After all, they went to school together.
The fox has always hated the bear. They never sit next to each other.
The bird won't have anything to do with the rabbit, but I hear he likes to court danger by sitting next to the fox.
My friend the bear always sits next to the bird. After all, they went to school together.
The fox has always hated the bear. They never sit next to each other.
The bird won't have anything to do with the rabbit, but I hear he likes to court danger by sitting next to the fox.
And the rabbit never sit left. I heard out one of them. The rabbit. Pop. Bird. There. I don't want to listen again, just in case.
The pompous fox? He wouldn't be caught dead sitting on the left. Far too pedestrian.
The rabbit never sits with the bird, but he loves the playful company of the bear.
The fox thinks the rabbit smells of elderberry. I couldn't see them sitting together.
The bird won't have anything to do with the rabbit, but I hear he likes to court danger by sitting next to the fox.
The fox has always hated the bear. Hey,
this. I am back. See, why would I sit?
Hold on tight, honey. Here it comes. 3, 2, 1. Don't give up yet. How about another?
The fox thinks the rabbit smells of elderberry. I couldn't see them sitting together.
The rabbit never sits with the bird, but he loves the playful company of the bear.
The pompous fox? Well, he wouldn't be caught dead.
So he's like, all right.
My friend the bear always sits next to the bird. After all, they went to school together.
The fox has always hated the bear. They never sit next to each other.
The bear? Yeah, no one is a bear.
The bird won't have anything to do with the rabbit, but I hear he likes to court danger by sitting next to the fox.
The fox thinks the rabbit smells of elderberry. I couldn't see them sitting together.
Never sits with the bird, but he loves the playful company of the bear.
The pompous fox? Well, he wouldn't be caught dead.
Hold on tight, honey. Here it comes. 3, 2, 1.
A party pooper.
dead shark!
Again. Okay.
My face. You have my face. It's our face. I'm beautiful. Always were. This feels so familiar. Are you all right, Audrey?
Alice, I cannot begin to tell you how good it is to see you. And this must be your wolf.
Audrey, meet Tom. He's my protector. My friend.
You both got here just in time. Now I understand why you don't like being called Alice.
The machine creates many of the same forms. At least, on the outside. On the inside, we're all pretty different.
Well, from now on, I'm gonna call you something other than Alice. It just doesn't suit you.
Oh? What do you have in mind?
How about... Allison?
It's not bad. Okay,
I'll try it out. But only if you can tell me what in heaven's name you're doing in Wilson's retreat.
Wilson, I almost forgot. I have to get back right away.
Are you crazy? Wilson's our enemy.
Do you even know him? Have you ever talked to him?
I've seen what he's done. That's good enough for me.
Look, it sounds like he has a plan to kill the Ink Demon. For good. And I think he can help us all. I just need to go back and hear him out.
Well, if it's true, you'll both need as much help as you can get. The Ink Demon won't go down without a fight. Tom and I will gather some of our friends. Anyone who's left. Good luck, Audrey.
You too, Allison.
Mind if I take this?
Beautiful people on this world, if you have brains or talent, you may just sneak through the gates. They just ask your name. They ask your name. They want you to attend. They ask you to speak. A silky voice with gorgeous lips is everyone's weak spot. I was reborn with my perfection stolen from me. Out to get it back, I'll rip this rotten world apart. Angels are beautiful. Angels are beautiful. I think the Ink Demon might have a point. They're talking about bringing this world peace. It is going to be. Where they butchered my boy. I think he's stuck. Dear Alice, I don't know if you will read these notes, but I'll keep having them. I hope you understand my words and the madness will fade from your mind in this strange dark place we find light and purpose. We are not left to just wander alone, craving beauty, power, not a meaningless thing. Even the heart of someone feeling complete can discover joy. We are not lost, waiting to be found. We are so much alike, born from the... We are well, like sisters, you and me. I wish you comfort and the wisdom. Batman. I can't even get my battery. Well, I have no batteries. They said he killed my lord. They said the ink demon fell. They said I was a false prophet. But I say my lord lives on. But I say, well, better watch back, can I?
This music box could make a good distraction if I can fix it.
It took me like hours to try to figure this puzzle out. I finally did though. Finally just started looking around at objects and then finally found it. I'm about to skip this video. I have a lot. Probably is my longest episode yet. At least I can bite about, I didn't die once. So, now let's bite. Let's just hope my little friend is not fixed.
Cause if he is, I am screwed.
The thing is, I have no battery. Like, nada. Cause the freaking game took one of my batteries. Accidentally saved my game, not loaded my game. But this is gonna be so much editing. Boy, you dropped down like 2 feet. Gosh, there's a ladder. Please say there's no wall.
There is no battery. Broken. Nope. Doesn't matter.
Well, like, everything in this... Like, this game has a few bugs. Definitely not near as many as security breach when it first came out. That thing needed to be fixed immediately. The only real bug that it has is characters getting stuck. Uh-oh. What have I done? What have I done? Such an idiot.
That's all the pieces for the music box.
I'll wait for him to pass on. Oh. Why won't it? I can't die! go that way. In my defense, it wouldn't let me talk. I'm not lying, it actually would not let me talk. How many batteries do I have? I have one battery, okay.
Now I just need to find a good place to put it.
Yeah, there's gonna be a lot of edit to this video.
Here goes nothing.
Let's be killed after that.
There you are. Thank goodness. Wilson's waiting for you downstairs in the laboratory when you're ready. But first, can I get your help with something?
Yes, sure.
Normally, I wouldn't ask this of a guest, but with all that's happening, I can't sneak out and get things like I usually do. Do you think you could pop round to the farmer's market back in town and find me a few ingredients? We're running quite low in the kitchen. And I was hoping we could all celebrate tonight with a lovely supper. Won't take but a moment if you go by train. Up to you. No pressure.
Stay clear of the door.